I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I set the world on fire.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh! Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son. Full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
We need a doctor, not a dead man.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations and there will be no
James and his cheery charity.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
Don't look straight into the light, pal.
Just like her.
You'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here. Just a little further.
Baba.
You can do it. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course, I'm
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once. So have fun.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything.
I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think...
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're such a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than me and Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Who do you mean, Dorkface here? Happy birthday, Dorkface.
Attention, everyone! It's time to cut the cake!
Andy, wait!
How's it going, pal?
Hey, happy birthday!
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer. I gave her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources. That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday. I would offer you a piece of cake, but...
Enjoying yourself? Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that. You're gonna be sorry, you little... How do you like that,
Daddy,
huh?
I told you not to act
Butch,
all official.
Butch, what do you think you're doing?
I
Leave him
you
alone.
I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
You all right, son?
Nonsense.
He didn't
People
hurt you,
always enjoy my little speeches.
Thanks for inviting me
Besides,
to your party.
Besides, that friend of yours could use a reminder that life is not all fun and games.
Are you having a nice time?
Ugh, this is supposed to be a party, you know?
Nice pit bull.
Fun?
What is that?
You should try it sometime,
Daddy. 3,000
so, what do you think we should call
what
our game?
Piece of...
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
Hey, you having a nice time? How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Who wants to go around all...
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. You never learn, do you? You can't help shooting your mouth off even when you know it's gonna get you a bloody nose. Uh-oh, your dad is giving me a look. I better let everybody else have a turn with the birthday boy. Do you think we surprised him?
You always have good ideas.
I'm sure of it, Amata. Never suspected a thing.
Yeah, I got one. The
now
Mackers.
Go on and enjoy yourself.
Super cool, right? This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Jeez, Wally.
Thanks
who's the head of the gang?
Family.
You or me?
I know
no
you were
way.
Busy with the water purifier. Everything's fine.
You're gonna be really sorry you messed with me.
Oh, sure. Nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as... I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about? That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's gonna be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done then. Why don't you get back to enjoying your party?
I wasn't worried. You can fix anything,
Jonas?
Right? Anyway,
hey, Doc.
I'm glad you
we're all
make
set
it.
Down here.
Thanks. I'll send him right down. How's it going, pal?
How are you enjoying the party, Mrs. Palmer? I helped with the decorations.
What about the tunnel rat?
Hey. That was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Ooh, I like that, Butch.
Oh, really? They're lovely.
I don't know.
You
I've got to think
such
about
a splendid job.
Maybe.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
You and your snakes and rats and wizards.
Shut
hello,
up,
Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job. Plus, well, I like parties.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me. What do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him. can do this. Having trouble with that red roach? Nasty little things. They pretty much keep to dark places, though. That's why there are always lights on in the vault. I know you can, and that's good. I'm not always going to be here to take care of you. You've got to learn to fend for yourself. Now, take your time. Breathe slowly. Sight down the barrel, and squeeze the trigger. Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega. Beginning and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year, you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. No, you're not. Really. When I started studying medicine, one of the first things I learned was how to spot a kid playing sick to get out of taking a test. You'll do fine. It's not so bad. Everyone has to take it when they're 16. I had to, you have to, and so does everyone else. And most everyone makes it through without a scratch. That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe. And you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Picture Take care, son. I got out of here. And good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right?
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
Morning, Jonas.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
Let's go
into
the storeroom, Amata.
What are you gonna do, Amata? Go run and tell your daddy on us?
Stay away from me!
No problem.
You think you're special because your daddy is the overseer?
Show it to her, Butch.
Get away from me! American
industry. I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again. And you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no! You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off, to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants. All finished?
Hey.
It's nice to know I can still be surprised. Pedicurist. I might have guessed manicurist, or even masseuse. But apparently, you're a foot person. Ha! Closer to reality than you might think. Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously, and look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Did you know Vault-Tec water and life support systems can sustain a vault for over 900 years without failure?
Good to see you. Here you are, Mr. Broch.
I'll see you tomorrow,
okay.
Right now.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
That is
Mr. Broch.
Right here to save you now. Is he letting you get back to work? Selfish and insubordinate. Just like
you need
wake
to
up.
Know these.
Come
things.
On, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you. He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, it's lucky I got here ahead of them. But we can't stand here talking. You've got to get out of here. Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. We don't have time for this! Trust me, security doesn't know about the tunnel. Just my father, and me. Maybe this pistol I stole from my father will make you feel better. Go ahead, take it. And then let's get out of here. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't... Wait for me.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Be careful! Tom!
Interfere with security.
was close.
He had to mess things up for everybody.
Stop, in the name of the overseer.
I told you, I don't know anything.
Be reasonable, Amata. Officer Mack may enjoy this, but I don't. Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend. I was worried about him. What does he have to do with any of this anyway?
Probably nothing, which is why you need to tell me where he is, so I can talk to him.
One more time.
Do what your dad says, Amata.
Stop it!
That'll do for now. Be reasonable, Amata. I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself. Oh, is that all? Is there anything else I can get you while you're here? You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again. I've dealt with your kind before, you little snot-nosed punk. You should have run like your coward of a father.
My God, what have you done? You killed him! Why would you kill my father? God. You actually opened it. Good, you're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him! So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No! Don't listen to me. Just go! Find your father! I have to go bury mine! No, I can't. Not with you, not now. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
Stop, in the name of the Overseer! What's the matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of your own blood? Ooh.